It's Halloween once again, so I will read you Creepypasta. Get comfy and sit down when I tell you the tale of Rumia. If you happen to be in Human Village and stay long enough, you might catch a psycho floating blob of darkness. Some still wonder what lies inside the blob, whilst many simple disregarded. Though there are quite a few who wear it. Why? I was getting around to that. There have been several incidents where a child, teenager, or anyone in general would accidentally or purposely venture out for a nightly stroll, out of sheer curiosity or to merely cause trouble after the sun had long gone down. This blob will greet them midway to their destination, through their stroll, etc., and lead them off in a complete different direction instead. Where were they sent to? Why, none other than the Forest of Dead. The blob will eventually reveal itself to be the human-eating yokai of darkness, Rumia. Charming her unsuspecting victim with her innocent demeanor and cuteness, she will slowly but surely lure them to their demise. Let's play, she will say, and then take off into the darkness of the forest not long after. As she led them deeper into the dark and eerie forest, a faint, musky scent could be picked up from deep within the forest if one's sense of smell was decent enough. Rumia's innocent act will slowly disappear, and then will be replaced by a smirk full of malice. Not only did her personality change, so did she. She will then go seek out her victim and lead them to a clearing in the forest where the moon shines brightly and in plain view. Concealing the remains of her past victims, but failing to be rid of the scent, some of her more recent mangled and decaying corpses gave off. It's this way, she will say in her childish voice, despite now being in her ex-form. Eventually reaching the clearing, the now silent yokai will allow her victim to enter before she did, a defiant plan forming in her mind all the while. Not knowing where the little blonde haired girl went, the victim looked around the area, becoming slightly worried that she had abandoned them. Just then, the full area became darker than it already was, making the moon appear to be duller than it truly was. Looking for someone? Came a dark and sinister voice. The voice seems to be close by, but it was too dark for them to actually see anything. Attempting to find a way out, the voice locked darkly and asked in a somewhat mocking tone, "Leaving so soon, are we?" There was a short pause. "Shame, and I was just starting to have fun," the voice added, feigning disappointment as this was said. The yokai observed the victim's reaction to all of this. "You humans amuse me," she mused. "It's a shame that you have to die so soon," she smirked as the victim froze, obviously fearing for their own life as this unknown voice continued to taunt and prolong their impending doom that would soon befall them. The yokai of darkness silently drew closer to the victim, smirking as the victim guessed then where she was. Everything was silent for a short period of time. "Look behind you." By doing so, they were greeted by a pair of demonic-looking eyes. The only thing that could be heard was the scream of pure agony as the victim was slowly eaten alive and devoured by the human-eating yokai, never to be heard from or seen again. Sometimes, if you happen to be passing by the area, you can occasionally hear screams from within the forest. Not many have dared to go out at night since. Perhaps you will be brave enough to go outside during the night and venture into that forest?